Hi everyone, welcome and welcome back to Be Extra. This is a knitting podcast. I am Stephanus. I am in Somerset, New Jersey. And Be Extra is, you know, a knitting podcast that celebrates everyone's creativity in the fiber world, you know. So be extra, knit what it is that you want, and don't be afraid in trying something new or repeating something that you have done before, and, you know, continue building your skills and, you know, and enjoy the process. So yeah, so what's new? How is everyone's 2 weeks so far? Last episode was 2 weeks ago, and if you watched the last episode, you would have heard me mentioning that I would go to New Orleans, Louisiana, and, you know, and I think I mentioned there's something special that I will include in this in the next episode, which is this episode. So I was in New Orleans, Louisiana, for a conference, and after the conference time, I had an afternoon with a good friend, and he actually is the friend that I met during pandemic when I started knitting a lot. It was at the beginning of the pandemic where we cannot go anywhere, and then I met a lot of my knitting friend through him, and I will explain it in the video. So I will place the video after this introduction, and you will see the full interview. It's a short interview between me and my friend. So my friend's name is Kinnan, and I'm not gonna go too much about Kinnan. I'm not gonna discuss too much about Kinnan here, because I will go over, or I will interview Kinnan in the video that I will add after this introduction. Yeah, so what else before we go to the interview part? I am still working on the same project that I have been working on for now. It's a full month, but I think I'm getting there. So I finished the, you know, the back panel when I was in Greece, Athens, which is February, 17 or 19. And now I'm almost done with the front. So you see this, not too much left. And then after that, it's just the sleeves, and I can finish that in a week. So hopefully one or two more weeks, and that will make it, you know, 1.5 weeks to finish this. I usually, I mean, it's not a race anyway, in finishing a garment, but I do acknowledge that, you know, this garment has been taking much longer time than my usual average working time for a sweater. First, because well, this is all over cable, and the yarn is pretty, even though it's DK, I would say this is light DK, so bordering sport weight, which I love. I am not complaining whatsoever. I enjoy the process of making it, and I'm not rushing this anyway, and I don't mind if I finish this when the temperature is already in the 70s or 80s in Somerset. I can still enjoy wearing it anyway, in the spring. It doesn't have, because we pretty much are in the spring at the moment in the East Coast. So, but you know, I will also enjoy it when the next winter rolls over. So, you know, I just love you are getting the exact color of this yarn with this lighting. I figure I'm trying something new, and I think I'm liking this lighting, light setting. Maybe my, you know, my eyeglasses is reflecting the O-light or the ring light a little bit. Maybe if I take off my glasses, you can see me better. But you get the idea. Yeah, but the color of this yarn is pretty true to color. And I just can't wait for to wear this thing. And also I will actually visit the Bay Area in May and in California. And the Bay Area never, you know, the temperature is never above 70 Fahrenheit, and it will go between 50 to 70 throughout the year. So this is a perfect garment to bring, you know, even though it's going to be fully spring by the time I get there. Yeah, and maybe I'll, you know, set another trip before May. So somewhere in April, maybe I'll go somewhere that is also still cool, or if not cold. So what I'm saying is I still have a lot of opportunities to enjoy this before the next winter. So now going back to my knitting friend, I realized that it's actually nice to connect with knitters wherever I go. And you know, now that I have this platform, this YouTube channel where I can, you know, place my interaction with the knitters wherever I travel to, I realized that I can start interviewing maybe knitting friends or any of you who are watching the channel who would like to, you know, meet up, and then we can knit, and you know, like I can interview you and to get to know you. So if you are, you know, interested in, you know, meeting me whenever I travel, let me know. Type in the comment section where you are watching from, and if I happen to be in your area, I will definitely, you know, I'll let you know, or I will announce it in the channel that hey, I'm, you know, May, whatever, I'm going to California in the Bay Area. If you're around, let me know. If I have time, you know, to meet up for a little knit and chat, we can have like a 10-minute interview. So it's a really quick interview, which you will see in the interview that I had with Keenan after this introduction part. So yeah, and also if you want to follow the channel, go ahead and subscribe. I know I never I one time I mentioned that I don't like to mention or to ask people to subscribe, but you know, I think this is a good opportunity to get connected with people, because I love to travel, I love to knit, I love to get connected with people, you know, knitting in the knitting community. And if you know, if we I can learn something from you and get to, you know, get or introduce ourselves, that would be nice, don't you think so? Yeah. So that's the idea. That is just something that I, you know, thought or started thinking. I'm like, huh, that's actually fun because, and you know, now I started to just record using my iPhone. It's actually recording in 4K, and my big camera is not even, you know, up to that resolution. So I was like, okay, It's not that difficult to, travel with my iPhone as my recording, and I'm actually using a Blue microphone. It's pretty really, really good cardioid pattern microphone, so it's pretty much getting rid of the surrounding sound, and it's just taking the the speaker with the pattern of noise, recording noise that it has. Anyway, it's anything podcast. What am I talking about recording? So that's what I have for now. Before we go to the the interview video part with Kenan, if you have anything you want to see me covering, or you want to see in this YouTube podcast for me to cover, let me know. Leave comments, and I just want to know what people are looking for, because I'm not a I as you know, I don't show a lot of my yarn collection, and or I don't talk a lot about the different yarn that that I like or I want to get, because I feel like I enjoy more of the actual knitting. And as you can see, I really more of a tonal person rather than really, colorful, wild, yarn kind of person. So I don't, but I still love indie dye, people who, make beautiful colors. And I guess I can start also highlighting, indeed, or dyers that I love in future episode. But what I like to cover or talk about a lot is, the actual or the actual knitting, and if people have, or if you have watched this YouTube or podcast channel, you know that I'm a left-handed knitter, so this is my left hand. I talk about a lot about, left-handed knitting. And you know what I mean by left-handed knitting if you just go back to my previous channel. So, I don't know, maybe people are annoyed with me whenever I talk about or getting too technical with left-handed knitting, but every now and then I will definitely place or upload some a little bit more technical video where I will go over some techniques that people can or I can share with people on when you knit with your left hand as your progressing hand. Anyway, so if you have any ideas or anything you want to see, I mean, if you want to see the yarn collection that I have, I mean, I can show, but it's really not, I don't have a lot of yarn, surprisingly, but I do like to make garments. So whenever I need to make garments, I will get, like sweater quantity of yarn, but I don't really collect a lot. So maybe I have 10 skeins right now that I haven't used, and those are the skeins that are not, like assigned for a specific sweater. So they're just like ex like one of those travel skein that I picked up using during my travel. So So this episode, it's pretty much going to be covering the interview with Kenan. And if you want to jump into the interview, please, I will place a marker on the YouTube where the interview starts. So I think what else? I don't think I have anything else right now. Let me see, just a second. But again, if you have ideas, let me know what you want to see, and in the next episode, I will cover. So hopefully by the next episode, this one will be finished, and hopefully I will be able to find an occasion to wear it before May event where I will go to California. So now, enjoy the interview of me with Kenan Goldsmith, or also known as the Knitting Bartender. Until next time, be extra, knit what you want, love what you knit, and yeah, let me know what you want to see, or if you have any ideas, or any suggestions for future episodes. Okay, see you, bye. Today I'm in New Orleans and I have a special guest. His name is Kenan Goldsmith. Hi, Kenan.
Hey.
Kenan, tell everyone how we met.
We met in a Zoom chat room during the pandemic for people who knit, and you were the only one in there. And we hung out and got along really well. And then we wound up joining a bigger group that I was already knitting with, and the rest is history.
Yeah, I remember it was the beginning of a pandemic in 2020, and I found this Zoom knit group that is open 24 hours. And on Friday night, I would sit by myself. And then one night, Keenan just came in while I was knitting by myself, and he was like, "Come over here, we have a group somewhere." That's how I met everyone.
Absolutely.
There I met a couple other, like six really close knitting friends from all over the world. Keenan lives in New Orleans. I live in Jersey, and there are other people. And I have been trying to meet everyone. So Keenan, tell us. So this is your own design, yeah? What you're wearing?
Okay. I designed this a few years ago. Designed it for myself, and there were a few people who were interested, but I didn't publish it. So if there are enough people who are, maybe.
Yeah, Kenan is amazing at cables. So this is all over cables that is knitted in pieces, right? So do you start with the back or the
Back
front?
and then the sleeves.
Work flat. I would definitely like to try knit this pattern.
You would have this done in like 2 days.
Oh yeah, it's worsted weight, yeah.
Worsted weight wool.
Worsted weight wolf. This one is from
This
Knitpick.
KnitPicks, yeah. I like the price of this. This is the wool of the Andes yarn.
And you have drafted this all the way from
Size small
small.
to 3XL.
And Keenan told me I can start with a large or extra large, or we'll see. And definitely I like the look of it. It's not too positive, what do you call, like ease,
Too much
having too much
positive.
positive ease. And yeah, and today we're actually wearing cable sweater weather here in New Orleans. It's about what, 60s?
64 degrees.
60, yeah. And you are working on
From KnitPicks, this is the fourth stage half kit.
And who is the designer
Her
of
name
this?
is Julia Maria Hagenbart, and I apologize
Okay.
if I just messed up your name, but
Yeah.
It should be Julia.
And this is very 3D structure.
Pleats.
And then at the end, there will be, you will add the color on the spine with a crochet needle, yeah?
Crochet contrast. And I'll probably go with kind of like this pea green color, since it's going to get pretty dark as I keep going and progressing in the fade.
Nice. Are you going to design more?
I would love to.
And so this is the second try in recording. I asked Kenan about the pattern for this sweater because I do want to start writing down my own pattern.
And, you know,
yeah,
life hits, you work a lot. So I've just enjoyed designing for myself.
It's good. It's fun to make something for yourself from your own, I don't know, creativity or whatever.
Well, that's what's fun about fiber arts, right? I mean, the possibilities are endless. That's the dangerous part, and that's why it's addictive.
At the same time, look at that. Look at
that's right. Stephanus probably has way more yarn than I do. I
mean, no,
he's got their hoard of yarn like a dragon sleeping on their gold.
Hey, we don't talk about that. Yeah. Well, also, Kenan is teaching me how to edit this video, so this is really a treat. But yeah, thanks, Kenan, for your time. And I hope you visit the East Coast. It's a horrible question. No, hopefully you if you visit New Jersey, we'll hang out.
That would be awesome.
Yeah. Anyway, talk to everyone soon. Bye.
Bye.